Hello friends, in previous video we have studied about a direct online starter, that is DOL starter. In this video we are going to study about the star delta starter for starting of three phase induction motor. So before starting with this video, let us see what are the learning objectives. So first of all, we are going to study about the star delta starter. And then we are going to study about theory of star delta starting. So let us start with this session. So first we are going to study about the star delta starter. Now this type of starter is used very commonly for most of the induction motor. But the only thing is that this type of starter can only be used for the delta connected motor and not for the star connected motor. So the reason for this you will understand as we proceed from the session. So let us see how the star delta starter looks. So figure A shows the diagram for the star delta starter. So if you see here, this is the rotor of our induction motor. Then this is the three phase stator. Okay. Now, this is our changeover switch. So the terminals A2, C2 and B2 are the three terminals of our changeover switch. So changeover switch can be at the start or at the run position depending upon the requirement. So when we are starting the induction motor, at that time the changeover switch will be at the start section here. So this B2 terminal will be connected over here. C2 terminal will be connected over here. A2 terminal will be connected over here. Let me show you how it will look. So at starting, this is how it will look. At the start, so B2, C2 and A2 terminals of the changeover switch are connected in this way. So in this condition, the stator of our induction motor will be connected in star, just as shown in figure B. Now, initially, as I have told you, the connections are like our stator is connected in the star. Now, once the motor picks up about 80% of its rated speed, the changeover switch will be thrown at the run position. So now let us see once the changeover switch is thrown at the run position, how the motor will look. So here what I have done, I have thrown this changeover switch at the run position. So here my B2 terminal is connected to run position, C2 is connected to run position, A2 is also connected to run position. Okay. So in this case, what will happen? As I have connected my motor in the run position, the stator of the induction motor will get connected in the delta, just as shown in figure C. So you can see A2 terminal where it is connected. See over here. This is the connection. Similarly for the C2. Similarly for the B2. Okay. So in this way, initially what we have done at starting, the motor was connected in star. And once the motor picked up 80% of its rated speed, it got connected in delta. Now you might be thinking why this is done. Like why we have to connect the motor first in star, then we have to connect it in delta. So let me tell you the reason for this. So what happens is when we connect our motor initially in star and then in delta, then the line current which will be drawn by the motor at the starting, it will get reduced to 1/3 of its value. When we are connecting motor at the starting without any starter, then the starting current of the motor is very high. Now this starting current can damage the stator winding of the induction motor, so our full motor can get damaged. So in order to prevent this damage, we are using the starters. This we have already seen. Now what is happening in case of star and delta starter? Initially the motor is connected in star, and then when the motor attains about 80% of the rated speed, it gets automatically connected in delta. Now, why we are doing this? Because when we are connecting motor initially in the star, then the starting current gets reduced by 1/3 of its value if it was directly connected in delta at the starting itself. Okay. Now, why this is happening? Because at the starting, when the stator windings are connected in the star, then we know that in star, V phase is equal to VL by root 3, where VL is equal to line voltage. So each phase will get the reduced voltage, that is 1 by root 3 times the actual line voltage. Also, the torque which is developed in the induction motor, it is directly proportional to the square of the voltage, whatever voltage is applied. So as the reduced voltage is applied, the starting torque will also be reduced to the 1/3, which will be obtained by the direct delta starting. So these are the two advantages. Our current will be reduced by 1/3. Also, our starting torque will be reduced by 1/3. Now, how this will happen, for that we are going to see one. So now let us study the theory of star delta starting. Now, as we have known that at starting, the motor is connected in star. So once the motor is connected in star at the starting, then the total voltage across each phase will be reduced by 1/√3 times the line voltage, because we know that in case of star, V phase is equal to 1/√3 VL, because VL is equal to √3 V phase. Now let us assume certain values. Let VL be the value of line voltage, IST star. Now let us assume certain values. So let VL be the value of the line voltage, then IST star P with the value of starting current per phase with the stator windings when they are connected in star, then IST star L be the value of the line current when the stator windings are connected in star. Now let us consider star connection. So for the star connection, we know that line current is equal to phase current. So obviously the two values of this current will be equal. So IST star L will be equal to IST star P. Now let us consider that VP is the value of the phase voltage, VL is the value of line voltage, then IST delta P with the starting current per phase. If the motor was directly connected in delta, okay? So IST delta P with the value of the starting current per phase by direct switching of the stator connected in delta. Similarly, IST delta L with the starting current drawn by the direct switching of motor winding in delta. So this is the line current and this is the phase current. Also, let ISC delta P be the value of the short circuit phase current if the windings were directly connected in delta. Similarly, ZE10 be the value of the standstill equivalent impedance per phase of the motor, which is referred to stator winding. So, how can we write this formula? We know that V is equal to IR, so I is equal to V by R. So, similarly, if the R is replaced by the impedance, what we will get? IST star P will be equal to VP divided by ZE10. Let it be equation number 1. But we are considering the star connection. So for the star connection, we know that line voltage is equal to √3 times phase voltage. So phase voltage will be equal to line voltage divided by √3. So VP is equal to VL divided by √3. So if we substitute this value of VP in equation number 1, so how can we modify equation number 1? So equation number 1 becomes IST star P is equal to, instead of VP, we will substitute VL by √3. So IST star P is equal to VL divided by √3 ZE10. Let it be equation number 2. Also, similar thing will happen in case of the delta. So IST delta P will be equal to VL by ZE10. Let it be equation number 3. But for delta connection, we know that line current is equal to √3 times of phase current. So our IST delta L will be equal to √3 IST delta P. So again, we can modify equation 3 as, just substitute this value. So IST delta L will be equal to √3 VL divided by ZE10. Let it be equation number 4. Now let us take ratio of equation 2 to equation 4. So what we will get? Starting line current with star delta starting divided by starting line current with direct delta starting will be equal to IST star P divided by IST delta L. So if we substitute the values of IST star P and IST delta L from the equation 2 and equation 4, what we will get? Starting line current with star delta starting divided by starting line current with direct delta starting, that is direct switching in delta, will be equal to VL divided by √3 ZE10 divided by √3 VL divided by ZE10. So if we cancel out certain terms, what we will get finally? Starting line current with star delta starting divided by starting line current with direct switching in delta is 1/√3. Let it be equation number 5. So if we rearrange this equation, what we will get? Starting line current with star delta starting is equal to 1 by 3 times the starting line current with direct switching in delta. So instead of connecting the motor directly in delta, if we use the star delta starting, then our starting current gets reduced by 1/3 of its value. So we can say that starting current from the main supply is 1/3 from that with the direct switching if we are using the star delta starter. Now similar thing can be said about the torque. So the starting torque with the star delta starting is equal to VL divided by root 3 square, because torque is proportional to square of the voltage. Similarly, starting torque with direct switching in delta will be VL square. So if you take the ratio, what do we get? Starting torque with star delta starting divided by starting torque with direct switching in delta is equal to bracket VL divided by root 3 square divided by VL square. Again, certain terms will get cancelled, and what we will get? The ratio of starting torque with star delta starting divided by starting torque with direct switching in delta is equal to 1 by 3. Let it be equation number 6. So again, if we rearrange this equation number 6, we will get starting torque with star delta starting is 1 by 3 times the starting torque with direct switching in delta. So also from equation 6, we can say that if we use the star delta starting, then our starting torque is also reduced by 1/3 of its value if the motor was directly connected in delta. So in this way, we are connecting the motor in star initially, and then in delta when it attains about 80% of the rated speed. Because of this type of connection, we are reducing the starting current by 1/3, and also we are reducing the starting torque by 1/3. Both these high value of the starting current and starting torque are very harmful for the induction motor. So to protect the induction motor from this damage, we are using the star delta starting. But the one thing that we have to remember is that we cannot use this type of starting for star connected motor, because see what we are doing, we are connecting initially motor in star and then in delta. This can only be done for the delta connected motors. So star delta starter is only used for the delta connected motors. So in this way, we have studied star delta starter for the three phase induction motor, and also we have studied how the current values and torque values are reduced. Thank you.